स्टार्टेड प्रार्थना यो ब्रह्माणं विदधाति पूर्वं यो वै वेदांश प्रणोति तस्मै तम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुरु वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा येनाक्षरसमाम्नायमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम् राइट सो वी हैव कवर्ड द बेसिक एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द लैंग्वेज इन द लास्ट क्लास एंड वी हैव मेड अवर फर्स्ट वर्ब फॉर्म हाउ ए वर्ब इज फॉर्म्ड इन संस्कृत एंड वी हैड द एक्स प्लस वाई फॉर्मूला एंड वी हैव आल्सो सीन द फाइव एलिमेंट्स दैट आर taught that are expressed by a kriya padam by a verb okay I will use the sanskrit terms from now on prakriti will be prakriti pratyaya will be pratyaya so we'll not use any english terms to avoid confusion and to keep the clarity okay so this is what we have learnt and we have also seen the purusha vachana linga kala the purusha and kala along with vachana belong to purusha kala along with vachana belong to kriya padam the linga along with vachana belongs to nama padam so nama padam the noun forms we will arrive at later not right now okay and this anupurvi practice is very important whenever you have time like take any pick some words like take this word or take this word व आ वा च आ च न आ न म वचनम लाइक दिस लिंगा ल ई ली म प्लस ग प्लस आ लिंगा लाइक दिस ब्रेक इनटू ऑल द कंस्टिट्यूएंट वर्णास व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट इन दैट ओके सो दैट इज वन थिंग देन वी हैव आल्सो लर्नड अबाउट द भाषा द वाक्य द पद how many kinds the two kinds of words and then the two divisions of the word both we have covered and then now we will see what is next so one we have also seen that x plus y formula and we will replace just x and we can form n number of verbs this way okay so when we use x is equal to pat then we add this purusha pratyaya This T is called Purusha Pratyaya. Okay, so Purusha Pratyaya for Vartamana Kala, Prathama Purusha and Eka Vachana is T. When we add T, it becomes Prathama Purusha, he, she, it, Kala, now, Vachana, one. So Patati in the Dhatu and Artha. The dhatu is patha and artha is to read. So he reads is the word, the meaning that is coming out of this. So we could just form the kriya pada, but we did not discuss the meaning of it. Okay, that is why now it is very important that we when we replace the x, we understand that the x is like these two parts are changed. Okay, dhatu plus artha are changed. For example, we have put krida. Krida, we all know Hindi may be we use krida, krida. Okay, the Telugu in Telugu this word is lot of times used krida. So Indian languages are much full of Sanskrit terms, Sanskrit words, and Sanskrit vocabulary as such. So it's not new for us when we learn Sanskrit. So krida is to play. Okay. To play, x is equal to play, y is equal to he now one. So he plays. in English plays, he plays or he is playing. Okay, this is what is the meaning. Now we are going to come to one important thing. In Sanskrita there is only one vartamana kala. The vartamana kala is very very like what to say, it's very only one vartamana kala is there, like that exact term I am not getting. We have to adjust for all kinds of present tense, like the present continuous, the present simple, the present perfect, and the present perfect continuous. Like in English we have, if you have like English grammar, if you have exposure to that, then you might have heard about these terms. So the all the present, like he plays, he is playing, he eats, he is eating, everything. Okay, so all the things are like, they will be always only one vartamana kala, only one what do you call expression. Okay, so the sunrise, so for the sarvakalika satya, for the eternal truths, we use present tense. We use present tense for many many situations. Okay, so this he is eating now is one present tense. The sun rises is one present tense. This man is generous, he donates a lot. This is all time truth, for many long time truth. So all such things are covered only under one vartamana kala. So we are not, I don't know why it is, because when Sanskrit can have three past tenses, I don't know why there is only one present tense. Okay, this is a little puzzle question for me. So defined she is in many other aspects. She covers so many things which other languages don't cover. But coming to present tense, we all are at loss. Like for the present day expressions, for the modern day, we try to use. So people ask, what is the expression for he is walking? What should I do? How should I distinguish between he walks and he is walking? I said, why do you always want something that exists in other language in this language? When you have a mother tongue, you have English, do you compare everything? Do you want everything in the other language? It's not necessary. So accept whatever is there in Sanskrit first. Okay, so ask me, how is this vyavastha in Sanskrit? Is there anything, or how should we put it? It's a good question, it's a valid question. I don't say it's not valid, but we don't have answers. But if you ask why is it not there, then there is no answer. The why is not the right question. What is there, we'll try to know, we will try to learn. And how should we put it? Okay, if it is not there, then how to maintain it? So there is one more vyavastha for that, we will come to know later. How to express the present continuous things in Sanskritam. So we use some other pratyaya kind of things, so that we will come to later. For now, we will understand that this vartamana kala for now is for all kinds of existing things that are right now going on. Sarvakalika, whichever is continuous, whichever is for present, it will be there in vartamana. So gacchati, pathati, kridati, like I am doing an MA, like I do MA for 2 years. So I am doing MA, I will keep doing it for 2 years. That is also present tense. Okay, so I don't have any other expression. I am eating now that I am going to complete in next 15 or 20 minutes. That is also in present tense. Okay, so on and so forth. Okay, so that. So now we will come to, okay, so one boy is now the next topic we are entering. One boy is reading and we say he reads. So pathati. Now two boys are reading. What to do? Okay, two boys read. It is changed in English also. Okay, one boy reads, two boys read. Dies has gone away from the verb. Dies has gone away. So there is a difference. Verb agrees with the noun or the subject. Sorry, not noun, subject. Verb agrees with the subject. So the boy reads. The boys read. So in Sanskrit, when it changes with the number, okay, agrees with the number also. The verb agrees with number of the subjects. So one boy is reading patati. Two boys are reading then. So there is another expression. So let us see how it goes. First we will see. Okay. So we are coming to another concept. Before the entering that, we will come to another concept. They have tried to bring down all the verbs at one place. The dhatus in Sanskrit. Dhatus are the kriya moola. Okay. The kriya basis are dhatus. All the dhatus they had put in one place, or all the kriyas they have seen. They didn't see the dhatus. They saw all the kriyas. The kriya padas in Sanskrit. They saw that there are some common elements. Okay. In the like in English we can compare taking the past tense. See, all the past tense, we will take some verbs, we will study their past tense. Okay, he goes, he went, that is go, went, it's entirely different word. Okay, eat, ate, entirely different word. Sleep, slept. Okay, learn, learnt or learned. Okay, then by what, teach, taught. So when we study all these verbs, then we try tend to categorize. Hey, some verbs are taking taught, bought. Okay, all these we'll put in one block. Some taking entirely different words like ate, like these things we'll put. Sleep and slept have something in common. Eat, ate does not have anything in common. Okay, but sleep, slept, at least the S-L-E, that much part, S-L-E-P, that much is common. So some verbs tend to bear some element of the present tense also. So such verbs we'll put in one category. For example, I'm telling, it's not there in English, or I don't know the exactly how English works in this. So coming to Sanskrit, they worked this way. They saw these forms of the present tense. So they didn't go to past tense. They went to present tense. They collected all the T forms, perhaps, I don't know, I was not there when it was happening, but I guess, like I am doing it, I guess if I were there, how would I do? So in the same way, they must have also done that. I just have that. So these are all anadi. We don't know exactly how it was all. It's such a developed science before so many centuries, such a highly developed and cultured grammar and linguistics we have got in Sanskrit, that we can only just say this. Just to put our put this namaskar on our head for all those people who done that, who did that. So they put all those kriyas at one place and observed that there are certain characteristics in these verbs. All these they worked out into 10 formats. 10 formats, 10 different types of verbs they found. All the kriya padas, all the T forms. So they said, okay, let these blocks, these 10 blocks be separate. Okay, from now on, we will call them with the first dhatu. So some dhatus, like some are like leaders, born leaders. So those dhatus came up and said, okay, we will represent this gana. Okay, they call gana. Gana is a group. So the first group, the bhu dhatu came and I will be the representative, he said. So they said, this is named after bhu. So this is bhu adi gana. So this gana, it's not a name at all. It's the dhatu itself. But the dhatu said, okay, I will represent. So, bhu adi gana. That gana which starts with bhu as its first dhatu and the rest of the dhatus follow. Okay. Then the second gana, they said, ad dhatu came. Okay, ad dhatu came. I'll be there. Ad dhatu. Okay, this is ad adi gana. So, this second gana is called adha. Some people name these ganas by number. Prathama gana, dvitiya gana, tritiya gana, chaturtha gana. So better we get, some books use this, some books use that. So the best thing to have, even English books don't touch Sanskrit terms at all. They'll say first, not conjugation, what they say. first category of verbs are blocks, vikarnas. I don't know what they say in English. Really, after dealing with these terms in Sanskrit, I really forgot what they say. It's not conjugation.
Conjugation. Haha, conjugation.
Conjugation. Okay, first conjugation, second conjugation. Okay, I thought I was confused. It's good. Thank you. So these conjugation. So they name this way. Okay, so we should be acquainted with all these terms. Okay, that happened. So that is also called vikarana. Gana and vikarana are similar terms. Okay. So first gana, second gana is same as first vikarana, second vikarana. So these vikaranas have got one pratyaya. What is a pratyaya? Again, we'll rewind one second. That it is something added to a prakriti. When a prakriti is there, it is added at the right side of it, at the end of it, at the right end of it. Okay, that is a pratyaya. So something is added. Okay, this pratyaya. But there is one more pratyaya that is coming, purusha pratyaya. So we have to add that. So what exactly happens is, first is the dhatu, the x. Second is this vikarna pratyaya. Then y comes. X plus y is there. So this is x plus a plus y. Something called a is coming in between x and y. And this a defines which category that dhatu belongs to. Okay, this exactly this a which is coming in between. So x is patha and y is ti. But we have patati. I asked you to practice Anupurvi more and more. This was the first class homework. Okay, you can do it now also. So pick up some 10 words including your name. Okay, your name also you can work your Anupurvi. You can work out my name. You can work out your teacher's name, your ashrama, whatever words you get in Sanskrit. Just 10 names you write and show me. That is your homework. Unless you do that, you will not understand this importance of this concept. Okay, why it is important, you won't understand. That's why please write it practically. Right. So this p, a, th, patha. This is pa, th. So as I told you, whenever the sandhi happens, that part is very important. So this part is not important. Pa, in pat, pa is not important. But tha is important. But okay. So this th has got t. T is this which is added, the y. This part, this much part is x. Pat is x. T, isn't it? Pat is a dhatu with halant. Okay, it did not have a. Okay, this t was x. Y. I'm sorry. T is y. So this x plus y is there. So this is the a which has come in between. And we see patati, don't you? Don't we? Here, what is it? Pat plus t is patati. Whereas it should have been patti, isn't it? It should have been patti. When pat and ti are added, patti should be there. How did it become patati? Ah, that a has come from this feature. Okay, so there is a lot of story. If I don't explain this in the beginning, people really ask me, why do you tell all this stuff in the beginning? They are children, they don't know anything. And for the beginners, you are telling all this, they'll be confused. I say, no, they won't be confused. It will save lot of pressure in the future. Unless you understand this vikarna pratyaya, you don't know which form, which dhatu is going to take. And why patati is patati and nash plus ti is nashyati. Why is it so? Chor plus ti, chorayati. Why is it so? They break their heads. Then they say, no, there are some ganas belong to this. Okay, they let them belong to different ganas. How should it affect the form? Why should it affect the form? How will we explain that? So that's why I explain it at the very first doorstep. When you enter into Sanskrit, you enter with the dhatu, you enter with this vikarna pratyaya information, all the dhatus, all the forms are in your hands. Now you can form any dhatu, any form, any Rupa, any prayoga, you can just do like that. You just have to just think, okay, this dhatu belongs to this. Okay, this form is going to be like this. So this is the outcome which is going to come very soon. We will discuss all that. Okay. I'm also telling, so that you might not feel pressure, you might not feel any kind of newness or what is exactly happening. Okay. So don't worry. I keep on repeating things. Okay. In my classes, I never say anything only once. I keep on repeating them whenever they'll come. Okay. So don't ever worry. So this first gana. So this first gana, as I said, the Bhu Dhatu came for its representation and we named it Bhuadi. Bhu plus Adi, Bhuadi. Bhuadi is a sandhi. Okay. It's a sandhi is happening here. Let's not fall into that. Just for now, we will understand. Bhu plus Adi is becoming Bhuadi. So Bhuadi gana has got A as its Vikarana Pratyaya. Okay. Bhuadi gana has got A as its Vikarana Pratyaya. So Pat plus A plus Ti is Pathati. So now you tell me, just you can unmute yourself and tell me how is Kreed plus Kreedati. How does Kreedati form? What is there in Kreedati?
Kreed plus A plus T.
Patati.
Pat plus A plus T.
That A we should not forget. So when you see Patati and I say the Dhatu is Pat, then we must know that there is a A in between the T and Pat. Okay. So that activity we will do. So this is how it forms. Pat and T come together. Then the A enters. Then Patati emerges. This is how a verb form in Sanskrit is formed. Okay, so this is the first. In the same manner, whoever dhatu, whichever dhatu is going, I feel dhatus are all people, like I don't see them as things, okay? They're all people and they come with lot of dresses and this dress he wears and he becomes this. So many imaginations run in my mind, some wild things. So this lust comes and lust says, like when we see that lust is taking lust a tea, then we find, okay, there is an A inside. You, whatever sounds come out of anything, your whole concentration should be on what has become in between. Lust is the dhatu, tea is the pratyaya, lust is X, tea is Y. There is something in between. What is that? There is A. That is Bhuadigana. If I will give you any number of, n number of Bhuadigana dhatus, you will just close your eyes, put a and make the form. Okay. So this is the first. Though there are more steps to come, I will tell you. It's not as simple as this. There are more, further more steps. And we will be slowly going to them. We will not be like hurrying anyway. Okay. So now we will come to Ekavachana so that we have dealt. So this is how it has formed. We have seen here. Now we will go to Dvivachana. Okay, so the same way Kreedati, Vasati. So the Kreed, the X is Vas. Now, okay, Kreed we have done, Vas we will do. Vas is X, it is to live. Vas is to live, to stay, to reside, to be precise, to reside. Okay, in a house we reside, right? So we say, we don't live in a house, we stay in a house, right? Living is different, staying is different. So that Vas is that. Okay, so what does Vasati mean in English? You can tell me.
He resides.
Yes, exactly. He resides. In the same way, Kreedati, he plays or she plays. Anyway, he, she, it plays. He, she, it resides. Whatever, whichever we talk about. Now we want they. Okay. So as I told you, in every step we have to remember, whenever the number we are dealing with, one singular, more than one, dual, more than two, plural. Okay, so now we are on more than one in dual step. Now there are two people. Okay, now the two people are reading, two people are sleeping, two people are playing, two people are residing, two people are shining, Lasati is to shine. Okay, so all these things they are doing. Now what, how to tell? Then that pratyaya, that X, we only need an X, right? We only need an X, that's all. We have all the X, we only need the Y. The X's are there. Now we need the Y. Y is taha. I'll give you the Y, it is taha. Now how will you make these? So I'll show you one example and next one you're going to tell yourself. So it is pat plus taha. Pat a taha pat. similarly. So any form you are going to take, or I mean any why you are going to take, any pratyaya that you are going to take of this gana, if the dhatu belongs to this gana, is going to take that a in between. Okay, so this is the rule for not just ti, for anything to come. Okay, all the pratyayas to come, all the vais to come in the future, this is the formula which is going to take place. Okay, so one boy is reading patati, two boys are reading patatah. Okay, and moreover, again I'll reiterate here, the verb does not change with linga, gender. So two boys studying patatah, one boy and one girl studying patatah, two girls studying patatah. Same with the next one, patati also, same, one boy is reading, one girl is reading, or a computer is reading, the PDF reader, we have just to put it on read mode and it is going on reading in a beautiful voice. Okay, so it is reading the yantra. Okay, so that way, anything is reading, it is patati, single. It only changes with the number, two people are reading, that it boys, girls, vastu, anything, it is patatah. Okay, and what about these kriyas also, you can tell me here, only we practice exercise. So I'll give you dhatu. Dhatu is lass. So lass is to shine. I want to say two people are shining. What I will say?
Lassatah.
Lassatah. So tathaiva pathatah, kridatah, vasatah, lassatah, all these things. Okay. Right. Now we will go to the next one. Now many people are there. There is a they too and a they. Okay. There is a he, there is a they too, and there is a they. Because for all practical purposes, we have to deal like that. We don't have any other term in English to equally tell the dual expression. Okay. So we always have to say they too, they too, they too. And to differentiate, we are using the same term. Then if I say they, you will feel something is half. Isn't it? After I say they too, when I say they, in our, like, it's human tendency to expect some other word, isn't it? So what I found a solution for that, even in Indian languages, I teach in the similar manner, I use some other term like they all or they me. They me. It looks very artificial in English. And sorry, I'm not here for English. I'm here for Sanskrit. Okay, I put English and all Indian languages aside, and I put Sanskrit in the highest altar. And I, whatever I speak, I want to make Sanskrit as clear and as near as possible through the language we know. So the language we are speaking now happens to be the medium to understand that. We know this language. Even if I'll kill this language, if I'll do any murder to this language, nothing wrong is going to happen. Because I'm not speaking English. If I'm giving any speech in English to an English public, I cannot do these mistakes. But I'm speaking to a person who wants to learn Sanskrit, and I don't have terms in English equivalent. What can I do? That's why I have compensated this way. And I'm really sorry for that. I should be saying sorry to English language for doing this. Okay. So they two, they many, or they both, they many. We will use such terms. Okay. So now we are coming to they many. He, they two, they both, and they many. Now they many has one pratyaya, that is called anti. Okay, anti. Ti, taha, anti. Actually, it is not anti, it is only this part. Beyond a. Whatever you heard beyond here, beyond a is that expression. But you cannot say anti, anti, you cannot say suddenly. That is why for the uccharana, for the pronunciation facilitation, we have put a. So for all the newcomers, we'll say it is anti. Okay, and we put a in the bracket so that it is not a part of the work we are going to do. Okay, this part, it will affect this part. If we'll put not, we'll not put this bracket, it is going to affect this part. That's why we will put a bracket. Now how we will add it to it? Similar manner, same like we see this here, pat aati patati, pat aatah patatah. Similarly, pat a anti patanti. That's why I didn't put it here. Okay, anti, I didn't put it here. A pat a anti patanti. Okay, so this is, so many people are reading. They many read. So they many can be again boys, They many can be girls. They many can be a mixed audience. They many can include things. They many read. Okay. So this is the first set of Vartamana Kala Dhatu forms. Okay. Vartamana Kala Rupani. Because this is going to be the base. If you understand this, this is going to be base for entire total number of verbs that we are going to deal. This is the basis, very basis. Okay. And this is very, very, very important that you understand this much. If you miss clarity here, you are going to miss clarity everywhere in the future. So I'll want to stay here for a little more time so that you get a very clear picture. You don't forget any step out of this. Okay. So I'll again come back and I'll repeat. There is a categorization of verbs, which is called Vikarana or Gana. They are showing different forms in the world. After seeing that and studying, they made this. And each category is defined or is distinguished by a feature called a Vikarana Pratyaya. And that Vikarana Pratyaya is going to be a form that is going to come in between the X and Y, the Dhatu and the Pratyaya, the Purusha Pratyaya. Okay, so the Dhatu plus something else plus Purusha Pratyaya will form the verb. So the verb form the final Kriyapada is equal to X plus A plus Y, where A is equal to Vikarana Pratyaya. X can be any dhatu, Y can be any pratyaya out of this ti, taha and anti. And we see that for the number change, there is a change of the forms which are attached. Change of Y, change of the Y. Okay. So it is the when Y, when person is equal to 1, Y is equal to T. When Y is equal to T, Y is equal to 1, the form is T. When Y is equal to 2, the form is taha. Okay, then Y is equal to 3, then it is anti, or the other way. Okay, so you understand it. So when we are dealing with two persons, Y equal to taha. When we are dealing with many persons, Y equal to anti. So like that, it is changing the number. Okay, so this is the entire rahasya of the Sanskrita dhatu. Okay, the first level. Okay, so this is Vadigana. So Vadigana dhatus like patha, krida, vasa, lasa, hasa, vada. Okay, many dhatus are there. We'll deal with them. All these are going to take all these forms similarly. Like hasa is to laugh. One person laughs, hasati. Two persons laugh, hasataha. Many persons laugh, hasanti. One person speaks, Vadati. Vada is the dhatu. Two persons speak, vadataha. Many persons speak, vadanti. Okay, so this is how it is going to be. Tathaiva patanti, kridanti, vasanti. Okay, now we will discuss about something else now. So this is done. Patati, patataha, patanti. So we have to get it by heart. There is no other way. So these some are basic things. So people, there is one more thing. I don't know if you have come across that, but it's my duty to remove that misconception that they say Sanskrit is a language of unnecessary memorizing. Okay, it's only about memorizing things that Sanskrit is all about. Rote memorization, that too. Memory not with meaning, but rote memorization. Because they have to say patati patata. Tell me one language on this whole earth which you are learning for the first time and you don't have to memorize anything. Is this possible? I ask a counter question. Whatever mud they have thrown onto the Sanskrit is a mud which is coming because of their emptiness in the brain. Nothing else. That person who is asking this question hasn't learned any language in this world. as it observed his own mother tongue. I started observing my own mother tongue after I learned Sanskrit. Okay, so I know how a foreigner looks at my language now because of Sanskrit. Okay, she has given me so many like internal things, details that I can now see what how languages work and not. Okay, so it's not about memorizing rotely. Now you know the meaning. Now you know what you are memorizing. Because you want to speak something, so you have to remember which form is that. Now you wanted to say, two boys are sitting there talking to each other. You want to tell that. Okay. Now how will you tell it unless you you memorize that taha is the form for two boys. You have to know that the pratyaya for two boys is going to be taha. So you know the dhatu for speaking. It is vada. So you will say vada taha. Two boys are speaking, you will say. So that much you have to memorize. There is no other choice. Okay, that is next. This dhatu, as we are speaking, in the previous class also we had said this. Dhatu is not existent in the world. This concept of dhatu happens to be in the language, not in the language, but only to learn the language, only to study the language, and only for meta purpose. We have this dhatu concept. So you don't find any use of dhatu in this world in the practically applied places, which is called prayoga. In the prayoga, dhatu won't be there. And you should never I don't say he is to go plus ing. I don't say this in English, right? He is to go plus ing. I'll say he is going. I don't say he is to eat plus ing. They say he is eating in the same way. To eat, to be, and to sleep, to talk are all verbs in English, verb roots in English. So we don't use them in the world as it is. He wants to go somewhere. There we say to go, and to is infinitive there. It has some grammatical purpose to serve. Here when we say, I say went, he went there. I didn't know, you didn't understand. What is went, you said? It is only to go, the past form of to go. Here, to is not doing any grammatical function. It is only telling the root, okay? Isn't it? So you do the prayoga of that infinitive to form, but not this one which is representing the dhatu form. Similarly, in Sanskritam also, you don't find this dhatu anywhere in the world. I am telling you this because after learning the language and dealing with the dhatus, they appear to us so real that we tend to associate with them as if they were in the world. Then we should remember in every step, okay, there is no smaller parts like this in the world at all. Okay, so that is another concept. Now, we won't be able to complete this, but still I'll try. Okay, this is another. Am I too fast? Like, are you able to follow this much? Huh? Okay, then we will attempt it. Okay, if it is heavier, we will cover it in the next class also. I'll try to explain in the next class also. Now that you have understood what why is for Prathama Purusha, all we did was he reads, they both read. They many read, isn't it? We only dealt with Prathama Purusha, he, she, it. Okay, he, she, it and they. Now, what if you are reading? You want to say to me, you are reading. How will you say that? So in English, we have you are, isn't it? Are is defining that. He is, you are, I am, isn't it? In English, we have such differences. How will a Sanskrit sentence be? And before all this, I should have told you that what you are speaking is a sentence. When you say pathati, it is he is reading the three words in English put together in Sanskrit. Because Sanskrit is an inflectional language, the x plus y is going to be only one part. Whereas in English, we have to use auxiliary verbs. We have to use some additional things. When I say reads, or when I say read, okay, it can mean I read, you read, we read, they read. It can mean anything. In Sanskrit, we don't have any ambiguity. When it is I read, it is different. When it is you read, it is different. When it is they read, it is different. Okay. And when it is he reads, it is different. When I say reads, then only you'll understand, okay, she is speaking about first person singular. English is differing only at that place. But in all other verb forms, English does not differ. So it is a little difficult for us to understand this concept. If you have it in your native tongue, in your mother tongue, then you will understand this. We have in Indian languages this difference. I don't know anything about other languages. Okay. So I think it is there in Russian. It is there in German. Okay. As far as I have known, it is there. The difference is there. For I and for you, for me, there are different verbs. But in English, it is not there. Okay. So here in Sanskrit, we do have, and we also have the number differences also. So welcome to a very grand language, which has like plenty of forms. Okay, so people will get tired memorizing, so many forms are there. But if you understand the formula, if you understand the technique, you need not memorize much. Okay, oh, so many verbs and so many things, do I have to memorize all these things? Only a fool will say that. You need not memorize all that. Now you know what a gana pratyaya is. Now you know what an x is. Now you know what a y is. You know all the concept. You just have to know how to combine them and make your verb. That's all. Okay. When you know how to cook, I'll give you ingredients. You can cook it, isn't it? Right? Like so many curries we make. I also always give the curries example. I tell you how to make one curry, one vegetable curry. You can use the same formula, you can cook some other vegetable curry as well. The simple level, same thing, not the special dishes. But the simple curries are all having the same principle. Okay. Cooking inevitably includes putting some water, adding fire, putting some oil. So in some more, in some less, these combinations only we have to learn. Similarly here also, in Sanskrit also we are going to do the same. So same as the Prathama Purusha, if you remember, Ti, Taha, Anti, we are going to have the next set of pratyayas for you. Okay. Now you are reading. What are the three possibilities? You single are reading. You two, you both are reading. And you many are reading. Because English has, this is much more, English is much more poorer when it comes to you. Okay, when it comes to he, it has at least he and they. But when it comes to you, there is only one you. One you should be defining all the three of Sanskrit, okay? All the three numbers of Sanskrit. So we will name it you single, you both, and you many. To avoid total confusion, I want to be damn clear regarding this. When I say you read, I don't want people to understand there are many people and they are reading. Because you can mean many in English. I don't want that confusion to carry over to Sanskrit. That's why I stop it at the gate. I put it outside. I say, you single, you both, and you many. Let us have clarity. Well, we have other words to compensate, right? So that's why this. So what if you single is reading? Okay, you single is reading. Now we will tell that. So for that, pratyaya is a C. C, the sa plus e, c. Okay. So now we are going to add it to our favorite dhatu, pat. Okay. Pat plus c. So when pat and c get together, there is something coming in between the a, x plus y, x plus a plus y. So that is a again because pat belongs to dvadi gana. So this is going to happen in every pratyaya and I am going to repeat it in every pratyaya. Okay, so pat c is pat plus a plus c pat c. Okay, now pat c is you are reading. Now I want to say you are laughing. And I already told you the X is as. Okay, the X for to laugh is as. Now you are laughing. We only need to add the C. I want to say he is laughing. I said hasati. Now I want to say you are laughing. I will say hasasi. Okay, you single. You single are laughing. Hasasi. You single are shining. Lasasi. You single are playing. Kridasi. You single are speaking. Vadasi. You single are residing. Vasasi. You single are falling down. Patasi. So, patasi, patasi, lasasi, kridasi, vasasi, vadasi. You. All. Whenever you see C, it is you single. Okay? Now I want to say, naturally, the next number is more than one is dual. Now you single has been done. Now we want to say, where there are two people at this place, you both. Now I want to say you both. And I say, this pratyaya, thaha. Okay? Thaha. It's a mahaprana. We should be very careful with this because we have one taha there. Patati, patataha there. So in taha, we should be very careful. While saying, many Indians don't say it properly. They don't distinguish between, they think that they are saying, but they don't say it. So it leads to a lot of confusion. We think they don't know. In fact, they are knowing it, but they can't say. So in our saying, we should be very clear with our tongue. So for the good pronunciation, let us do prayer to Saraswati Devi. Enough prayer to her to make us say the right things rightly. Because Sanskrit, you are going to ruin everything if you are saying it wrongly. Okay, everything will fall down, crash. Okay, and what you say, you write. That is where people miss things. They say, what is wrong if I say it wrongly? If you say it wrongly, you write it wrong. Okay, so there is a very big connection to patha, thaha. Patha, thaha. So, pat plus thaha is equal to pat a thaha. Now, I have many people. Okay, you many. You single, patasi. You both, patha thaha. You many. Patatha. There is only the lope of visarga. Visarga is missing. That's all. So, si, thaha, tha are the vice for you. All use. You single, you both, you many. Si, thaha, tha. Okay. So, the next we will cover. Uttama Purusha, the I. When it comes to I, we will cover the next. Okay. I want to stop it here. And before concluding, I want to just come back to what we have studied. So X plus Y, Kridati, Patati. So we have understood that for the there are ganas, different ganas for dhatus, and there is a vikarana pratyaya for each dhatu, which comes after the dhatu and before the pratyaya, before the purusha pratyaya. And that is the whole deciding factor for all the dhatu ganas. So which gana that dhatu belongs to, we will put that gana pratyaya before the purusha pratyaya, and we can form all over. So this is the formula for making all the dhatus. And when it is he singular, he dual, and he many, or they both and they many, so we have found out that it is ti, taha, and anti. When we say anti, I is only for ucharana, they many. Okay, in the similar manner we will do all the dhatus, or other, just we will change the X, we will have one meaning in our mind, and we will express it through adding these pratyas. We want to say two boys are laughing, then we find the dhatus for laugh. So how the steps go, I will define everything in the next class. Once we complete the Uttama Purusha also, then I will define how we are, the steps of making the dhatus, that I will tell. Okay. So we have also covered Madhyama Purusha. Madhyama Purusha is you. You in English has only single word, so we will make it you single, you both, and you many. So for you single, it is a C, the Y is a C. For the you both, it is Y is equal to thaha, thaha. And for you many, Y is equal to tha. Okay. So similarly, when we say patha, we want to say you are reading, you single are reading, patati. When I want to say you both are laughing, I'll say hasathaha. When I want to say you many are residing, I'll say vasatha. So this is how, what meaning we want to say, what dhatu it is called in Sanskrit, what gana it belongs to, what pratyaya I have to add. Okay, we'll do it in detail. तस्य प्रजाभ्यः परिपालयन् तान्यायेन मार्गेण मुनिः मनीषा गोब्राह्मणेभ्यः शुभमस्तु नित्यं लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु नमो नमः सर्वं श्रीराम मिलिष्यामः
नमस्ते थैंक यू